The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st Canto, 15th Chapter, text number 37, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on December 15th, 1973, in Los Angeles.
Yudhishthira, anyone, any experienced man can see how things are going on. One has to possess such perfect eyes. When these things are in progressive way, what is this? Lobha, greediness. Anita, falsehood. Jimha means diplomacy. And hingsha, violence or jealousy. When these things will increase, one should know that the influence of Kali Yuga is increasing. Anyone can understand. This world, this material world is so made that these things are very prominent. Greediness, kama lobha dayascha, lusty desires and greediness, kama and lobha. Generally, people are attached to these things. Then diplomacy, how to satisfy my lusty desires, my greediness. But the king was so responsible that now he wanted to retire. There is no other way. As far as possible, he controlled. That is king's business, government business, is to control these things. And citizen must be happy in every way. Even Maharaj Yudhishthira's time, there was no excessive heat or cold. Neither there was prominence of disease or pestilence, famine, these things were absent. Because Yudhishthira Maharaj himself was very pious and he conducted his government in such a way the people were also pious. Jajjad acharati sreshta lokastat anuvartati. If the leaders are perfect, then the citizens will be perfect. If the leaders are rascals, just like in your country, now your president is caught up. You see such an exalted post, he is occupied by a person who is subjected to so many criticisms. Why? The Caesar's wife must be above suspicion. The king or the president, why he should be under suspicion? And if he is under suspicion, then immediately he should resign. Oh, people are now suspecting. But this rascal will not resign. You see? Just see how much our leaders are polluted. He has been charged with so many things. And even why he? Everyone is. He is weak, therefore he has been caught up. That's all. He is not so perfect diplomat. Otherwise, he would have not been caught. So, leaders must be perfect. Therefore, according to Vedic civilization, at least three persons in the society. The first, the priest or the spiritual master who are engaged in teaching people about religiosity, he must be perfect, above suspicion. Similarly, public leader, he must be also above suspicion. A Brahmana means priest also, he must be above suspicion. And the king must be above suspicion. Then things will go on. But there is no such restriction. Nowadays it is the days of vote. Any rascal, if he gets vote, somehow or other, then he occupies the exalted post. That is also written in the Srimad Bhagavatam. And in the Kali Yuga, there will be no consideration who is fit to occupy the exalted post of presidency or royal throne. Simply, somehow or other, by hook and crook, he will occupy the seat. That's what people are suffering. It is not nowadays in democratic days, the government by the people, government for the people. So, if the government is by the people, yes, you select your representative. If you are a fool, then you will select another fool. So, Bhagavad says, Savir Varaha Ustra Kharoi Sangstruta Purusha Pasu. Any man who is not a devotee, Krishna conscious, devotee of God, then he may be in an exalted post, but he is praised by some people who are exactly like Shaw means dog, and Vir Varaha means pigs who eat stool. Savir Varaha, Vir Varaha. And Ustra means camel. And Ustra Kharoi, Khara means ass. Savir Varaha, Ustra Kharoi. If a person who is not a devotee is praised or is exalted, then the praisers, the persons who is praising him, he must be among these animals. Dog, camel, pig, and ass. So the whole population is like that. Like dog, like camel, like ass, and like birbara. Pig, the stool eater, the whole population, that's the present moment. So he must elect another big animal who is also in this category. Because he has no knowledge. If you take votes from the camels, to whom he will vote? Another big camel? That's all. If you take votes from the dog, then whom he will elect? Another big dog? Therefore, anyone who is not a devotee of God, Krishna, he is either of these animals. And if he is praised, it is to be understood that he is being praised by the similar type of animals. So if we remain Savir Varaha Ustra Khara, then we must elect another big Savir Varaha Ustra Khara. So how there can be good situation of this state? It is not possible. Therefore, the public must be educated so that they may not elect another big dog or big camel or big ass to the exalted post. It is the public's fault. Nowadays, it is democratic days, so why should you complain against such and such person or president. You have elected him. Now you find fault with him. So it was your fault that you elected such a rascal, Sabir Barahusto. This is very right conclusion. So why they have been described as dog? Dog means is very faithful to his master. But if you pass through him without any fault, he'll bark. Go. That is dog's fault. One qualification is that he is very faithful to the master. But to the others, he is inimical always. In your country you have got experience. They have written, beware of dog. And if you pass, you are not entering the house, still unnecessarily the dog will bark. Even if he is on the top of veranda corridor, by seeing another unknown person, he will bark. That is offensive. But that is dog's business. And at the present moment, the dog is happy only when he has got a good master. Otherwise dog is not happy. He's still dog. He cannot eat, he has no eating, he has no place, he's lean and thin, you have seen. But he has got a good master, he is very stout, fatty, and very expert in barking. So this is dog's qualification. He's very faithful. So at the present moment, people are like that. They are being educated, but technologists or computer expert or this, that, so many. The father spends so much money, he becomes an expert. But if he does not get a good master to employ him, he is useless. He is useless. His technological knowledge will be useless if he does not get a master. So therefore, the modern education system is to create dogs. He will never be happy unless he gets a good master. Actually, we are constitutionally all dogs. But we do not know whom to serve. That is our misunderstanding. Actually, every one of us, servant, that's a fact. But we are missing the point where to engage ourselves in good service. That is Krishna. We have to serve. You cannot avoid this. If you do not serve Krishna, then you will have to serve Maya. That's all. But you have to serve. So in that respect, if you do not know who is the best master, then we'll have to serve our senses, our lusty desires. If I do not become servant of Krishna, then I shall become desire to my lusty desires for sex life. I have to become servant. That's a fact. You cannot become master. Therefore, the most intelligent person is he who knows that why shall I serve my lusty desires? Why not serve Krishna? Because I have to serve. This is intelligent. So, then again, sabirvaraha. Birvaraha means the stool eater. It has no discrimination. Anyone who is eating anything available, he is like birvaraha. He has no discrimination. A human being should have discrimination. Eatable, everything is eatable. Stool is also eatable. Does it mean a human being should eat eatable stool? No. It is eatable for the pigs, for the hogs, not for you. Similarly, a human being who does not know what is eatable for him, he is just like this, birbara, hog, who has no discrimination. Oh, everything is all right. Eat, everything is all right. That is birbara. And ustro, Ushtra means camel. Camel enjoys his own blood. The camel eats thorny twigs. So the tongue is cut and the blood comes out and the blood is mixed up with the thorns and he finds it very tasteful. He's tasting his own blood and he's finding very tasteful. Similarly, everyone in this material world is enjoying sex life. He is enjoying his own blood, but he is thinking it is very good enjoyment. That is camel's enjoyment. One drop of semina is manufactured by so much blood. So unnecessarily we discharge semina means we are enjoying spending our own blood. But the camel does not know. Similarly, camel like man does not know. Therefore he falls diseased. It is to be used only for purpose of having good children, not for enjoyment. There is false enjoyment. So therefore it has been described camel. And ass. Ass means fool number one. Because he works very hard. He carries the washerman's load of cloth, 2 tons of, but not a single cloth belongs to him. Not a single cloth. And he will agree to carry so big burden. What is the profit? The profit is that the washerman will give a little morsel of grass and he is satisfied. This rascal does not know I can get grass anywhere. Why shall I be employed by this washerman? And another ass's qualification is that when he goes for sexual intercourse, the lady ass kicks on his face. Fart, 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 fart. You have seen it? So these karmis, they are like ass. They will eat pieces of bread. And the lady karmi will kick on his face at the time of sex intercourse and he is very happy. And for this purpose, he has no time. Sir, I have no time. He is very busy. He goes to a karmi office, he will say, oh, I cannot see, I cannot talk, I am very busy. What is the result of your business? Now I will eat 2 pieces of bread at night and my wife will kick on my face. Just see the ass. Therefore, how Bhagavata has selected the specific animals, how they are suffering. Very instructive. Sabir Varaho Stakhar. He forgets his own business, that he has got this human form of life to understand why I am suffering, what is the remedy, how to become relieved from this problem. He has forgotten that. Simply he is busy earning money. Diva chate haya rajan kutumma bharaninava. These karmis, they are thinking that dehapatta kalatradishu asasu api sasaneshu tasya nidana pramatta tasya nidanam pasannapi na pasati. For want of real knowledge, Atma-jnana. First of all, one has to learn actually what he is. Is he this body or something else? That is the beginning. But they do not know. He thinks that I am body, deha. And because from this body I have got relationship with my wife, or she is my great friend, and the children, they are my soldiers. They will protect me. Dehapatra kalatradishu atmasainyas. He is very safe. I have got good wife. I have got good children. They will save me. Nobody will save you, sir. When death will come, you have to give your own account. If you are going to be next life a dog, not your wife, children, or nation, or community, or anyone will save you. No. Nobody can save you. The same example as I have given many times. When the aeroplane they are going on, but if one aeroplane is in danger, no other aeroplane can save him, but his minister. Similarly, every one of us is responsible for my own work. Nobody. Even in material world, suppose you have done something wrong, and you are condemned, you are criminal, you are condemned to death. Will your wife, will your children, will your family, will your community, will save you? No, nobody can save you. So, therefore, those who are thinking that this material atmosphere, relatives, will save me, they're mistaken, they're ass. They do not know that every individual being is responsible for his own work. And therefore we must be very careful. Now, why should I waste my time in working hard? What is my problem? These things have to be known. Therefore Vedic injunction is that how will we save? Then tadvijnanarthamsa gurumeva vigacchet. Then you must approach to a bona fide spiritual master. He will let you know how he will say. Otherwise your so-called society, friendship and love will not save you. So, Yudhisthira Maharaj, such a exalted king, and the battle of Kurukshetra was fought for Yudhisthira Maharaj. Krishna wanted that Duryodhana is not the fit person. Krishna had no business to take part in the battle, because he is God. Samoham sarva bhuteshu name deshasthina priya. He has no enemy. And who? Nobody can become his enemy. If he becomes enemy of Krishna, he will be vanquished. Therefore, he has no enemy. So, why he took part in the battlefield? Because he wanted this Yudhisthira Maharaj, the pious king, he should occupy the throne. So that is the mission of Krishna. Yada yada hi dhanma saglani bhavati paritrana sadhunam vinashaya yudhisthira dharma samasthapanartha. So Yudhisthira Maharaj is another name was Dharmaraj. Dharmaraj. So, dharma samasthapanartha. So to enthrone Maharaj Yudhisthira, because king is representative of God. That is Vedic conception. King or president, the chief of the executive. He should be exactly the representative of God. As Guru is representative of God. Similarly, the king or president is also representative of God. In every planet, because every planet, Ishavasamidam Sarvam, everything belongs to God. Bhoktaram Jagatavasam Sarvaluk Maheshwaram. I am the supreme owner of every planet. So every planet is the property of Krishna. Therefore, to govern that planet, there must be a king who is actually representative of Krishna. The king's business or the president's business is to see that the citizens, they mistakenly have come to this material world to enjoy sense gratification. These should be trained up in such a way that they can go back to home, back to God. That is king's responsibility. Similarly, that is father's responsibility. Similarly, that is guru's, spiritual master's responsibility. Similarly, the relative's responsibility. Suppose one has no father and mother, then it is the responsibility of the relative. It is the responsibility of the king. The whole target is how to train the citizen, go back to home, back to God. Because they have come from God. For Krishna Bhuliyajivi Bhagavan Chakare, he has come to this material world to enjoy false sense gratification. And he is loitering throughout the whole universe. Simply where is better sense gratification, better sense gratification. But he will never be happy by sense gratification. That is not possible. He is forgotten what is actually happiness. Actual happiness is not sense gratification. That is described in the Bhagavad Gita. Sukham atyantikam jat tat otindriya grahyam. What is real happiness, that is to be understood beyond sense gratification. Not sense gratification. Therefore you will find nobody is happy. Enough he has got facility for sense gratification. Ask anybody if you are satisfied fully. No, that is not possible. Because that is not happiness, that is illusion. That is illusion. We are accepting false thing as happiness. That is not happiness. Happiness beyond sense gratification. Sukham atyantikam jat tat atindriya grahyam. Atindriya means these senses, when they are purified, with that senses, when you try to enjoy, then that is real happiness. That is real happiness. Just like if your tongue is diseased, or if you are diseased, then you cannot taste what is actually Rasagulla taste. Because the tongue is detestful, you cannot enjoy it. Similarly, so long your senses are diseased in condition, you cannot enjoy senses. It has to be purified. That purification method is this Krishna consciousness. You purify your senses. Sarvapadhi vininmiktam tatparatena nirmalam. Nirmalam means purified. So, how these things can be purified? Sarvapadhi vininmiktam. You have to be free from all designation. At the present moment I am thinking, this is my hand. I am American, therefore this is my American hand. I am Indian, therefore it is my Indian hand. So you have to forget this, or you have to purify. This hand is neither American, nor African, nor Indian. This hand belongs to Krishna. This is purification. So long you will engage this hand under illusion for American service and Indian service, you will never get happiness. You purify this hand, that this hand belongs to Krishna. Therefore, it should be engaged in cleansing the temple with my hand. Then you'll be satisfied. Similarly, your tongue, similarly your legs, similarly everything, all senses. When you are purified of all this designation, sarvapadhi vininmuktam, tatparatena nirmalam, when with that purified senses, you will engage the senses, rishikena rishikesa sevanam, in the service of the master of the senses, then will be happy. This is Krishna consciousness. Otherwise, will never be happy. So the representative of God, the king, he is very responsible position, the king or president. So as soon as they take the post, for his own sense attribution, he will be charged with so many fault things. So when he is also purified, therefore Krishna wanted that such purified soul is Maharaj Yudhisthira, he should be posted, he should be enthroned. That is the battle of Kurukshetra.